Okay, here we are. I wanted to have a quick chat. I was probably going to try and do both magazines that I received today, but I don't think we're going to have time. I wanted to have a quick look at Counterfact. It's a new magazine that's come out. This is issue number one, and it's by the One Small Step group of guys. And this review, well, it's not a review because I haven't finished reading the entire thing. This quick set of feedback is probably going to come across as I have the hates on for these OSS guys, because I didn't really like the Ares magazine that much, or I didn't particularly like the game. I did like some of the Ares magazine. This magazine I have high hopes for. Not had, I have high hopes for. Here's the thing that I was excited about. If you go back and look at some of the old Fire and Movement magazines, they would have a review of a game, and then they would have a chap, the designer, like Frank Chadwick, would write a rebuttal about the game, about the re critique. He obviously was given an opportunity to, respond. And typically the response was, it was humorous and it was interesting and it was game related, and I think it was meant in an honest fashion. The commentary came back in an honest fashion as opposed to a disingenuous type of politeness or whatever. And the only reason that struck me as being cool is that I've read half a dozen of the, maybe even a dozen of the Fire and Movement magazines now. And I really enjoyed the back and forth and the insightful commentary from both the reviewers and the writers, the designers. And it was clear when substandard reviewers wrote, they really got their asses handed to them by the designers, and there was a lot more visceral response. So what has that got to do with Counterfact? I was a little unclear about what Counterfact might actually be about. But so far, this magazine is a similar style to Fire and Movement, except that it's all in that format of review, commentary, and then rebuttal response from the designer. So you get this first article, and it's about breaking the chains. And if you've read or watched any of my videos on that game, there's no real love lost for that title with me. I think it's a nice game. I don't think it does all the things that it could do as well as it could. So anyway, this dude, John Compton, PhD, must be a smart guy, and he works somewhere in DC, probably for a think tank or for the, DoD, who knows. I started reading some of the article, and he spent quite a bit of time offering a lot of background on the situation. I said, this is really kind of cool. All right, I'm getting into it. He starts dealing with the game and the puffery and the BS comes out in his commentary about the game, and it calls into question a lot of the elements of the game that, to me, he's missing the point about what's wrong with the game. Well, that's fine. So you read this very long-winded article and provide some analysis, all that sort of stuff. This is a well-laid-out magazine. It's nice to read and all that sort of stuff. I don't like the glossy paper, but hey, there you go. Well, then we have a rebuttal from John Gokowski. And man, talk about disingenuous. I mean, I don't know what you're thinking here, John. You start out by saying you applaud Mr. Compton's criticism and that you'd love to redesign or design the next game in the series with him. You really don't want to do that. I mean, you may as well. The net of your response is piss off. You don't know what you're talking about. And the fact that you waste so much space in this magazine that I'm paying a lot of money for, re-quoting what's already in the article, it's the most pathetic rebuttal I've read for your game design or for a game design ever. It's a complete waste of space in the entire magazine. And while you may be on point with the facts that you raise about what's wrong with the review, you trolling out, rolling out the standard, "Oh, you must not have played the game. I don't know what game you're playing," answer or is not a way to prove your point about the fact that the reviewer doesn't know what he's talking about. The reviewer may not have played the game. you need to answer his questions as though he has, and then highlight them, and then use the game mechanics and what's going on in the game to represent where he's wrong. The fact is, the game's broken from the perspective of your scale and your dice, the dice ranges that you use, and some of your rules about how things work with actual missile systems and things like that. You may work in the industry, but I can look on Wikipedia and see the ranges of these weapons and know that for some of them, I don't have to be in the hex to use them, but I got to be in your game. So you're wrong. It's just wrong, and it doesn't work. Now, if that's a consideration for the design, to make the design work, then that's fine, but you don't kind of hold that out. What you do here in this rebuttal is you just crap all over the guy in a backhanded way, saying, hey, thanks for all the response. Let's build a game together. You don't want to build the game together. If I didn't know better, I'd say you were both PhDs in the same department and didn't like each other. So, thanks guys for wasting my freaking time. There's 16 pages of bullshit, all right? Let's speak plainly. Thank God Andy Nunes wrote a fantastic article here, which is a wonderful background on this particular battle. There's a game in here, which I've read most of. The rules here for the game, this is the Mule Shoe Salient title, really well laid out, beautiful color. The counters are nice. The counters came in, where are they? They're here somewhere. You don't really need to see them, it's not a big deal. There's a little play chart here, there's the map, quite a nice map. Sorry about the split screen thing. They've changed the way the split screen works. I used to be able to make it into a small square on one corner so you didn't have to see my entire ugly mug, just a little bit of it. I don't know where the counters are. The counters are nice. They're nothing, you know, nothing to write home about, but they're nice. The rules are well laid out. This looks like a really interesting system for the American Civil War that I'd be interested in actually trying at some point, and may actually motivate me to look into the rest of the system, because I've yet to find an American Civil War system that I can readily adopt. Yeah, you can see the counters here. Here's graphical images of them, or pictures of them, right? So it's all very colorful, very nice. Great article by Andy. So we go through this whole exercise, right? And then we got another review, and here's this dude who did the artwork for this game at the Neuville-Chapelle. And man, I don't know. Did you not get paid, Tom? Tom, here you are. Dude, did you not get paid? Wow. Your nitpicking and whining about the artillery and how artillery works, you could say that for any game and the way games apply the artillery rules, and in particular scatter, right? I mean, you're bitching, and it's bitching. It's not critical review. It's bitching about the way artillery works. I think 2 full pages. Wow. I tuned out after that and just decided that whatever your opinion was, I didn't care about it, and I'm not going to read it. Preview of Hussar, and now this is where the magazine falls more into advertorial than article. Richard writes a nice long article, and there's an AAR in here for Hussar, which is the base system for the Mule Salient game. Nice long AAR. And the review, if you want to call it that, or preview, actually doesn't say anything about, in summary, in the final details, about the game in terms of what the guy thought of it. Rather than let me tell you things, read the AAR. Okay. This was a cute little piece, Wargaming by the Rules of War. Vince, I thought that was pretty funny, little article. It's just a little piece of nonsense. It's kind of fun. Okay. So that's that. And that's 10 minutes, right? So 9.5 minutes. I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to talk about the war diary next, and we'll have a conversation about that.